If you watch the ghost hunting shows, you've seen the K2 meter. It measures electromagnetic fields. If you put it up against an electrical box, it'll go crazy.
Mm-hmm.
If you sit it on a table, it shouldn't. As you know, we've been seeing a lot of lights flashing tonight.
We saw an awful lot.
Yes.
And the very weird thing, too, is at times it actually seemed responsive to
yes.
questions.
Right.
Which I can't make any logical sense of.
Yeah, and as we're talking here shooting the video, it's responding a little bit.
And it probably won't. Well, there it goes. Oh, yeah, but I mean, earlier... It was crazy. It was actually bottoming all the way into the red with no change in anything electronic near it.
Right.
So this is how it goes, Jeff. Like I said, it can be extremely boring. As the night goes on, there's a bewitching hour, which is usually around 9 p.m. And that's when sometimes, for most investigators, as we say, it picks up. I don't know why, but... Around 9 p.m., hopefully we might be able to get a little bit more interaction than a couple of blinking lights.
We've got night vision goggles. Allows you to see about 50 feet in the...
Now we were joking. Yeah, you know it's coming. We were joking earlier about the old movie Silence of the Lambs.
Yes.
And this is literally, this is the kind of thing that the killer, Buffalo Bill, actually had on when he had the final showdown with Jodie Foster.
Yes.
That's actually what he was wearing.
I have not seen Jodie Foster through these yet. I keep trying.
There's always hope.
Hasn't happened yet.
Well, when the restraining order ends.
Exactly, yes. This is a trail camera. So a lot of people use these for hunting. To see where the deer are going, where the animals are going. It's motion sensitive. So, you know, stick it in a room where you might get some activity. If something sets it off, it'll shoot off a couple pictures. Sometimes you see things moving, sometimes you don't.
Mm-hmm.
I like to bring my laptop with me. When I record audio, I like to sit down, listen to it for a while, see if we get any weird things that we're not expecting, which you can confirm that we've gotten some weird things.
I heard your name being said by no one in the room.
Yeah, which makes me very uneasy. I don't like that.
Here's the lights. We're in here. They're right here.
Now this is not something that you see every day. Here's another little artifact. What home wouldn't be complete without that, right? This is something that was handcrafted by, the name is what, Thomas?
Thomas Day.
Thomas Day.
During the Civil War.
Mm-hmm.
He, at one point, was a slave, became a free man. He was made to make the furniture when he was a slave. When he became a free man, he went back and bought the furniture that he had been forced to make. And this is one of the pieces.
And they say that there is something unusual that will happen to anybody who sits on this. Tony Ann was telling me that people will... Well, let's just say experience things.
Yeah.
I'm not making this up. I don't know what to make of it, but every time I come up here, I get about here, and I get these racking chills. Now, this could be my mind screwing with me. I'm not trying to draw a conclusion. I'm not trying to be dramatic. I'm just letting you know what I'm experiencing.
Go ahead, move that compass again.
Now this just went off.
Yeah.
It's not now, you can't see it, but it was just jumping. Playing games.
See, what's interesting about that, the K2 really could be the cell phone, it could be Wi-Fi. There shouldn't be anything moving.
Moving a compass.
A magnetic compass.
Yeah. And this is the same table that we saw the cord fly off
yes.
earlier as well.
And
interesting. A little girl apparently had something terrible happen to her up here. It's a very old building. And what you see here, you see the little white device here and then here. These talk to each other. That is a motion detector. If something breaks and goes through there, then an alarm's gonna go off. Over here is a special kind of teddy bear. Well, what little girl could resist a teddy bear is the theory. And as you can see, there's really nothing else much to play with for a little kid up here. So, if that teddy bear should be moved, even slightly touched, then it lights up and another alarm goes off. And that has been set up for some time, and so far nothing has happened. But we had an awful lot of electronic readings up here, which did seem kind of odd because it was near nothing electronic and seemed actually responsive to some questions that were being asked.